كلا إن الإنسان ليطغى.
Nay, but man doth transgress all bounds. Surah Al-Alaq, verse 6.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back to Reflections. Awesome to have you with us, talking about this incredible chapter of the Quran, Surah Al-Alaq, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us so many incredible things about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the hardships that he faced, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that you and I could sit in our living room and be Muslim today, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refutes the contentions of Abu Jahl when he says, "Kalla la illam yantahi." Kalla, as we said before, is a article used to refute, but refute in a way that disturbs the person who has these ideas. So, for example, let's say I said, "The sun is purple," and you say, "Kalla." So by saying kalla, that means I've said something so ridiculous that you're refuting it, not just saying la, but kalla, meaning you're wrong and actually you're ignorant, is the feeling. So they say harf an-nafi wa zajr, which means a article of negation, and also disturbs the one who had these false contentions. And that's why in English it's translated as nay, but that doesn't really give you the feeling. In fact, maybe some people don't even know what nay means anymore, because it's a very old word. And that's why I say that there is definitely a need for a new translation of Quran in a more contemporary language that can give you the emotion of the Quran. So Allah says, "Kalla," refuting the contentions or ideas of Abu Jahl, that he wanted to stop the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he wanted to refute him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he wanted to keep him from praying. Allah says, "Lanasfa'a." Safa'a in Arabic means to grab someone really harshly. Yani yu'khad bi shiddah. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Lanasfa'a." And this is called nun at-tawkid al-khafifa, meaning that not only is he going to be grabbed, but for sure, without a doubt, if he doesn't stop this, he's going to be seized. And also the form of the verb is mudari' with nun al-jama', meaning we will seize him. Instead of saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Rabbu Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it said we indeed will seize this person bin nasiyah, by his forelock. Now the Arabs, they used to use this as an idiom to say that someone was completely put under the control and surrendered to someone when they were taken by their nasiyah, their forehead. That's why the Prophet said in dua, "Nasiyati biyadik," that I'm completely under your control. But here it's used literally, that if he doesn't stop doing this, if he doesn't cease, we are indeed going to seize him and make him surrender by grabbing his forelock, his forehead here. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the forehead, meaning the brain, the mindset of Abu Jahl, when he says, "Nasiyatin kadhibatin khati'a." Wow. Which means a lying, deceitful, evil forelock. And what's interesting is science shows that this part of the brain is where people lie. Lying comes from here. So this is one of the miracles of the Quran. But more importantly, we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the mindset of Abu Jahl. كَاذِبَ خَاطِئَ, that he's a liar, evil, and that he's also wrong in his contentions. فَلْيَدْعُ نَادِيَ, and this fa means, then let him call Nadia. And this was revealed because Abu Jahl, one day he came to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he saw him praying. Maybe someone asked, the Prophet prayed before Laylatul Isra wa Mi'raj, but I thought prayer became obligatory later on. Here, as most ulama mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was praying nafil prayers. And he said that if Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't stop, I will call Nadiyati. Nadiya is a word which means I will call those people who sit in my gatherings to attack him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلْيَدْعُ نَادِعَ فَلْيَدْعُ نَادِيَ سَنَدْعُ زَبَانِيَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and then we will call زَبَانِيَ. The word زَبَانِيَ from زَبَن means to push, دَفْعَ بِشِدَّةِ, to push someone with great ferocity. But here it means the malaika, Meaning that if Abu Jahl tries to attack the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam with his nadia, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with zabariya, with these malaika who are with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah says, kalla la tuti'hu. Indeed, no. He will never be able to harm you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La tuti'hu. So don't obey him. And here it means la takhafu. Don't fear him. Don't allow him to intimidate you. Wasjud waqtarib. Make sujood and continue to draw nearer to Allah. Iqtirab is on the form of ifti'al, which means draw nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we understand that under hard times and difficulties, the Muslim should not give up salah. Because under the threat of Abu Jahl, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was ordered to continue praying. So it could mean la tuti'u, don't obey him when he tries to make you stop with salah. Waqtarib. Now the question is, what about us Muslims who don't pray and there's no Abu Jahl around us? There was a study that said less than 40% of Muslims pray 5 times a day. What's the Abu Jahl that stops us from praying 5 times a day? Is our own jahl. Fala tuti'u, don't obey your own jahl. Wasjud. Make sujood, waqtarib, draw nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So while we can point our fingers at all the abah al jahal in the world, if we ourselves are not able to establish worship in our own life, the only Abu Jahl we have to blame is ourselves. Thank you for watching Reflections. I'm your host, Abang Suhaib Web. Alhamdulillah. Please stay tuned for more episodes in the future. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.